Hello, my dear students of class 12th. I, Anish Moses from USAI Gorakhpur, will be starting a new chapter today. The name of the chapter is The Lost Spring, and it belongs from this Flamingo book. That is chapter number 2. Prior to it, I have taught the last lesson, which was chapter 1 from the same book itself. And by clicking to this I button, you can get straight forwarded to that video. You can also get online books, which I have inscribed in my description box. By clicking to that web address, you will be forwarded to that website in which you can get these online books. So, let's start this chapter, The Lost Spring. Now, this chapter, you will be finding that this chapter is divided into two parts. The first part of this chapter name is, Sometimes I Find a Rupee in the Garbage. And the second part is, I want to drive a car. So, now these two parts belong to this chapter. Now, the theme, now whether either these both topics are different, these both stories are from different children, from different areas. Now, but the thing is that the theme is totally same. The theme does not differ. The theme is totally belongs to this poverty and the child labor, in which we will be finding in the chapter that various other children of different parts in the nation are just having the same criteria, in which they don't have that much amount and they are earning for their livelihood and they are in a poverty condition. Now, the narrator of this chapter name is Anish Jung, and she clearly depicts the clear picture of these children, and she narrates in her story while telling the type of scenario in which these people are living. Now, in the first part, Sometime I Find a Rupee in the Garbage, we will find a boy named Sahib-e-Alam, his story, and in this story, he is a rag picker. This boy is working as a rag picker. He is a very small boy in that area of Simapuri, which is in the outskirts of New Delhi. He is living over there and he daily collects rags and he just picks rags and he just he's holding a bag like he's just collecting all the rags. You must have seen from the roadside small children gathering the rags and they are just going with a bag in their back. Now, this narrator Anish Jung, he is daily seeing these boys who are just working like that, and while she is seeing, one day she stops this boy named Sahib-e-Alam and she asks ki why he is doing such type of work and is he not interested in going to schools. Now, when she asks this question to Sahib-e-Alam, Sahib-e-Alam replies in a very docile and a very happy and a polite manner that there is no school near to his area where he is living. As I have already told you, he was living in the outskirts of New Delhi. Delhi, in the outer area of New Delhi, where they are not getting more facilities. And same is the thing he is telling, that he is not getting any of the school nearby. That's why he is not going to school. If in case he gets a school, he will definitely go. In the same way, this narrator asks Sahib-e-Alam that, okay, when I will start a school in your area, will you come in that school? In that case, Sahib-e-Alam tells, yes, definitely, when a school is started in his area, he will definitely come. So, that was the thing which was told by Anish Jung to the Sahib-e-Alam. And after that, it has been told by Anish Jung that she is seeing him, seeing his poverty. And after some days, she meets him again, and now this boy is coming along with his lot of friends. 2-3 boys, small boys more, were there with him, and now they are wearing a toned shoes and some of them were bare feet. So now, after few days again, this Anish Jung meets with this boy Sahib-e-Alam, and now Sahib-e-Alam asks her, that is your school ready? Can we come to your school now? In that case, Anish Jung becomes a bit humiliated. She thinks that she have done a wrong thing by telling this, by asking this Sahib-e-Alam for this school, because it was just a genuine question which she asked with Sahib-e-Alam, and there were no any schools which she was making. Now, in that case, she was a bit humiliated, and herself she was thinking about these poor children. And now, when she saw their feet, she asked them कि why you people are why you children are not wearing that slippers or any of the shoes. In that case, some of the boys said that कि it's a habit, it's a it's a nature in which they are not wearing, it's a type of a ritual in which they don't wear shoes. Some of them were saying that कि नहीं, they don't have any shoes, or if they have, they will wear in any of the festival time. So such type of various other excuses these boys gave, but no one told the correct thing that they were really very poor and that's why they are not wearing. That thing was known, clearly known by them is young, that because these boys are very poor, that's why they are not wearing their shoes. She Anis Jung now remember her past when she came to know about a boy. It was in her past when she knew one boy who was very rich at that time, and because he also never had shoes, he prayed to God for a shoes, and on the next day itself he got a new pair of shoes. But these children like Sahib Alam, they are very small and they are very poor and they will never get shoes. She herself knew. She also knew that instead his name was Sahib Alam, that means that Lord of Universe, but he can never be a king of any area because he is living in such a slum area. As I have already told you that these slum people, now when she comes to know about these slum people, that they are living in Simapuri. Now these Simapuri people are moreover poor, and these Simapuri people have migrated from Dhaka, Bangladesh. And now they are, because over there when they were living, they used to cultivate, they used to do farming, but unfortunately due to heavy rain or by flood, their whole crops were destroyed. And once their crops were destroyed, they migrated to India in New Delhi, Simapuri, so that they can get some job over here and they can earn something for their livelihood. Now due to that reason, they migrated to Simapuri. And once they are in here, Simapuri, they are living as they are living in a very small huts. They have covered their homes with tarpaulin and such type of old type of homes they are making, which seems that they are very very poor. Now when they are living in such type of home, now she is Anis Jung is now thinking that she that they must be, because they are very poor, they are not getting that much food for themselves, and that's why these boys are not going to school, that's why they have not got any type of education. She also comes to know about these boys that because they have migrated to Simapur, they have got one ration card. Due to that, only these ration cards have got two purposes with them. First is to give vote, and the second is to get ration or such type of food grains. That was the two purpose of which they have got this ration card, and only two purpose is being fulfilled by this type of ration card. So these all things Anis Jung is describing in this part of thing. And but one thing more she is telling, that for these people who are living in Simapuri, just for example, these father of Sahib Alam and the people who are living, who are elder, they, for them this garbage means that a means of survival, because by selling garbage only they can get some amount in which they can earn their livelihood. By selling some of the garbage, by getting some of things from garbage, they can sell it, they will be getting, and after selling it they will get some of the amount, and after getting some of the amount they can buy food grains. But for these small boys who are doing rag picking, for them it is a wonder. For example, if they are searching in a garbage and if they are getting 10 rupees or any of the costly items, they will be very happy with it and it will be considered as a wonder for them because a small boy has searched. So this was the case which was being described by Anis Jung. After few years, now again Anis Jung meet this boy Sahib Alam. Now as it was told earlier, the meaning of the name Sahib Alam was Lord of Universe. Sorry. But now at this time, this Sahib Alam is no more his own master now, but he is working in a tea shop, in a tea stall. And he is working in a tea stall, and because he is working in a tea stall, he is getting 800 rupees per month, and he is also getting his food over there. And at this time, he is no more holding any of the rag in his shoulder, but he is picking up a canister which is filled with oil, and he is working over there, and now Sahib-e-Alam is living over there, and he thinks, and now Sahib-e-Alam thinks that whatever thing he wanted to be, he have become, and he don't have any other dreams in his eyes, and only this was the thing for which he was made, and like this only he will do his, he will work the whole entire life. So this was the part first in which a boy's story, Sahib-e-Alam's story, was described, in which he was living in a great poverty, picking up the rags, he was picking up the garbages so as to earn his livelihood. So it was the part first. Now coming on to the part second, I want to drive a car. In this, it will be clearly shown, it is clearly telling about a story about a boy whose name is Mukesh. Annie's young goes to the house of Mukesh, and she finds, which is in Firozabad. Now while she goes to that boy house named Mukesh in Firozabad, she finds that these all people who are working in a glass bangle factory, because you must be knowing that Firozabad is famous for the glass bangles, and mostly entirely these poor families and these families which are living in a very slum area, these all families are making glass, they are making bangles, and while they are making bangles, they are just selling it, and by selling it, they are getting some of the amount for their livelihood. Now, the thing is, because they are getting some of the amount as their livelihood, they don't want to overcome it, or they don't want to change their family business. What this generation is been doing, they want to continue with that. For example, grandfather did the same job, father is doing the same job, now the children are doing the same job, that is making glass bangle industry. Now, because these people are making glass bangle, now these have no other job, only they are doing this type of hereditary job. Now, Mukesh grandmother meets with Annie's young come to their home for an interview. Now Mukesh grandmother tells her that it's our family job and we will continue doing this only, and because we don't have any other opportunity to work, we'll be doing the same job, because this job gives them satisfaction, this job gives them gives them some of the amount which they can earn, and also they get some recognition that yes, they are working in slum and they are getting some of the amount. Now moving ahead, when she Annie's young also sees Savita over there, who is a very small girl working in that glass bangle industry, she becomes very much desperate, knowing that such a small girl is working in that heated furnace in which lots and lots of light is emitted, and due to that light and gases, Savita's eyes can also get damaged, or due to that pollution, many of the things, many of the lung failure or many of the disease can also occur to such a small girl. She also comes to know, Annie's young also comes to know that who is working in this glass furnace, in this glass industry, mostly workers or employees' eye gets destroyed because of this gas. Now it is told about this small girl Savita, that Savita being a very small girl, she is from since childhood, she is working in that glass furnace, and in that furnace she will be destroying even her lungs, her eyes, but then also she is making bangles, and she herself don't know what is the meaning of that bangles and what these bangles symbolize in her life when she will grow up, when she will get married, because it symbolize her own suhag, which she will be coming to know when she becomes elder. And at that time she also Annie's young also tells about that these people, because they have made a home over there in that slum area, they have done a very huge thing in this entire life that was very difficult. So that was the thinking of these people who were living in that slum making this glass bangles. And also grandmother thinks that it is the God's destiny that they are living in that area, they were given such type of work that the whole entire family is doing. Also Annie Jung asked them, have they not tried to work something else, tried to improve their business, so in that case, Annie Jung also asked them, whether they have not tried to make a group in which they can just form a group, they can just take their business in a next level, a higher level. In that case, grandmother also thinks, because it's the destiny of God that they have to live, it's their own karma in which they have to live in such poverty and then they have to do their work. So that's what the grandmother is also saying, and she also tells ki because if they try to improve their business, police and various other politicians, they don't, or the aristocratic people, they don't allow them to do either. If they start to work, they just cast hold them and they stop them doing their any improved work. So that is what thinking grandmother is also saying. But in case when Anish Jung is asking Mukesh that what he wants to be in his life, at that time Mukesh tells clearly that he wants to be a motor mechanic and he wants to work as a motor mechanic in any of the firm. He don't want to become a pilot, but he wants to become a motor mechanic. After listening this, Anish Jung also realized, because these people are living in such a slum, they don't have a dream desire to become a pilot, then to only become a motor mechanic. So that was the thing that Anish Jung realizes after meeting these two type of people, Sahib-e-Alam and Mukesh. That is what the thing which comes in the mind of Anish Jung, that the people are living in a stricken poverty and they don't even, after even getting means opportunity also, they are not able to collect these type of opportunities to better to basify themselves. Now also it is said in this chapter, it is very important question that is asked in the board examination, that at times it has been asked in the exams that, but because Sahib-e-Alam and Mukesh, both of them were living in the slum area, both of them were poor, but what were the critical difference, what was the main difference in which you will keep Sahib-e-Alam and Mukesh? As yes, it is correct that both were living in the poverty, the correct answer would be Sahib-e-Alam never wanted to see himself in any other post. As I've told you, he started to work as a worked in a tea stall. He never wanted to grow up. He wanted to stay at that position only because he thinks. But in the position of Mukesh, his family was a glass bangle making family in Firozabad. But he always wanted to grow. And once when Anish Jung asked him that what he wants to be in the future, he clearly tells that he wants to be a motor mechanic. So that is the most important question that will come across in the board exams. And this type of question is always asked. Also, it has been asked about the furnace in which these people are working, in the glass bangle furnace, means in the glass bangle industry, what type of critical problems physically they are facing while they are working. Their eyes get damaged, their lungs get damaged. It's a child labor in which a small girl like Sapita is working. So this type of questions are also being asked. So over here it was the theme of this chapter, the lost spring. Now here will be following questions which you have to do in your question book, in your answer book.
Now here comes the first question from the book. What could be some of the reasons for the migration of people from villages to cities? What were the reasons for which these people from Bangladesh, from Dhaka, migrated to Sima Puri village? So you have to reply, what was the reason, what was the main reason in which these people migrated? Now coming to the second question. Would you agree that promises made to poor children are rarely kept? Why do you think this happens in the incidences narrated in the text? Now over here you have to tell that what the promise which narrated it as well as various people do to children, like for example various other elite class people do various promises to the poor children. Do you think that these type of promises are kept? You have to link the chapter also in which you have studied, that was any promise done to this Sahib-e-Alam, was it fulfilled? You have to link that thing also. Also question number 3. What forces conspire to keep the workers in the bangle industry of Firozabad in poverty? Means what all forces do conspire, why these people are conspired to live in that such slum area itself, why they can't rise to any of the higher level, why they can't form any of the groups in which they could improve their business. This type of answer means this type of thing also you have to write in your copy. Next question, talking about the text. First, how in your opinion can Mukesh realize his dream? Now, what dreams? First, you have to tell that what dreams he have, and also you have to tell that why did he said to have be like a motor mechanic? Why he wanted to become only a motor mechanic? Why did he never thinks to become a pilot? That's what you have to also tell in this answer. Next question. Mention the hazards of working in the glass bangle industry. So I have told you while teaching that what were the hazards, what were the outcomes, what were the demerits in working in this glass industry, and also you have to tell what all problem these people used to face. Last question, why should child labor be eliminated and how? So you have to tell why the child labor is to be eliminated and what all rules, what all regulation government is making, and how being a student you can eliminate this type of child labor. So these all question answers you have to do in your copy, and before doing these question answers, first thing is you have to write the chapter name, the narrator name, and you have to find at least 10 difficult word meanings from the chapter. And then you have to write the summary, at least 120 words. You have to write the summary. And after then only you have to complete these 6 questions which are given in your textbook. At the present moment, you can just pause this video and you can just write these all question answers. Also, the chapter, the full chapter I have given in my description box. You can click to the link and the previous chapters, previous ignition class link is also given in my description. You can just click onto it and you can view all these videos. Also, it has been advised to the students that if there is any problem in any of the question or if anything is not understood, they can just comment on my video and I'll definitely reply to it. Now, stay safe, stay at your home. All the best.